Congressman Himes, you've obviously now heard of this tweet. What do you make of the president's language?
You know, Anderson, we're 2 days into the new year, and Freudians all over the world have already had the best year ever. And, you know, I guess apart from that, you know, three thoughts on this, you know, need for the president to demonstrate that his is bigger and stronger than anybody else's. Number one, why would you want to goad this unpredictable leader of North Korea to maybe demonstrate his capabilities? That would get real very quickly. Number two, you know, again, I guess the president regards this as a show of strength, but as everybody who's ever been in a, you know, first grade playground recognizes, it's usually the person who's most aggressively pounding their chest that is in fact the weak one on the playground. And number three, and here's what really troubles me, Anderson, you know, remember we started the day today with the tweet in which the president took credit for the fact that there were no airplane crashes in the United States. And what really troubles me about that and all of the other tweets and now this latest tweet is that we've gotten to a place, a very weird place, where it really doesn't matter what the president of the United States says anymore, because it is so bizarre, strange, not true, infantile. And we've just never lived in a country where what the president of the United States says doesn't really matter.